morning. This is Dr. Rajkumar Arya, Associate Professor in Department of Chemical Engineering, NIT Jalandhar. Today I am going to explain how to model the lumped jacket. So in previous lectures, actually we have talked about modeling of jacketed reactors, the CSTR with jackets, with perfectly batched mixed jackets. Then we have talked about another thing, the CSTR, non-isothermal CSTR with the plug flow jacket. And in plug flow case, we have taken the average temperature inside the jacket. In case of bell mix, we are taking the jacket inside the jacket flow is perfectly bell mix. Practically all these two are not achieved 100% inside the jacket. So the another alternative way is that we can divide the jacket into several volumes of equal volume each other. So let's say this is the reactor wall, and here we have outside of that we have the jacket. So previously we have considered the entire thing is one jacket. Now what can be considered here, the jacket is divided into the several segments. So here in this picture we are divided into four segments of equal volume. So if we want to transfer the total heat Q, so total heat Q is now the divided into four equal parts. The same amount of energy will be transferred from this zone to this jacket, second zone to second jacket, third zone to third jacket, and fourth zone to fourth jacket. So as we can improve, means increase more number of jackets, so in this case we can easily achieve the condition of perfectly well mixed jacket, and it is always desirable here. So considering these four lumps of equal volume, so in this particular case we can write energy balance equation in that way. So this is the energy accumulated within the material here of the jacket here in the first jacket here. So this is rho g vg by 4 and cj by 4 tj 1. This is actually is the fluid here. The fluid is entering to the lump 1. So this is flow rate fj, density rho j, heat capacity cj, and inlet temperature is Tj0, outlet temperature is Tj1, because it will achieve the temperature Tj1 here. This segment is getting the means energy UAh by 4. So Ah is total heat transfer area. So here we have divided it by 4 actually. T minus Tj1, so T is temperature of the metal ball or the reactor ball. Tj1 is the perfectly well mixed temperature of the jacket. Same way we can write the equation for second lumps. So here density is same, volume is same, so and heat capacity is same, where temperature is Tj2. For this case, volumetric flow rate is same, density is same, heat capacity is same. Inlet temperature for this zone is Tj1. Outlet temperature is Tj2, because this much energy temperature would be achieved here. And this second term, this will also gain UAh by 4, and temperature here would be T of reactor minus Tj2 of the this particular lumps. Same way we can write for third lumps. So rho j bj by 4 cj Tj3 by dt equal to fj rho j cj Tj2 minus Tj3 plus UAh by 4 T minus Tj3. So this segment have the inlet temperature Tj2, outlet temperature Tj3, and the well mixed temperature of this zone is TJ3. Fourth lump is rho j bj by 4 cj tj 4 by tj 4 upon dt equal to fj rho j cj tj 3 minus tj 4 plus u ah by 4 t minus tj 4. So similarly we can write n number of the means the equations so to achieve the better well mixed conditions, and this would be a good alternative to get the well mixed jackets, or you can say the better control of the reactors in order to maintain the proper temperature inside the reactors. So this is all about the modeling of lump jacket model. Thank you.